I'm going to get you to take a look at this period from February 16th to February 20th. What I will add is that shortly after the cardiac cath, I had severe shortness of breath at rest. Breathing in, nothing happening, which was reported to medical staff. The next day, on the 17th, acute cardiogenic pulmonary edema was diagnosed. It wasn't actually disclosed at the time. One thing they did in advance of cardiac cath, they arranged the BUN to CR daily blood tests. Okay. And I'll let you guess what complications were extant going into surgery on the 20th.
On the 20th. Okay. Rio really climbs. You had worsening renal function, although your creatinine climbs to a lesser extent. So I don't know why you'd go into cardiogenic edema after the cath. Did they do a left ventriculogram when you did that? They report on your cath report, did they report a pressure gradient? Can I see the cath report one more?
Yeah, of course.
I'm just wondering if they if they intervened on your pressure gradient. What I was looking for is this. So they did put, they actually did instrument your left ventricle. That would be the mechanism where your aortic valve could have been injured for sure.
And so if my aortic valve was ruptured, my lungs would fill with fluid quite rapidly. And then that would trigger spikes in the BUN-CR.
That would fit.
I'd be into that place now where not many people have been, and I was there for 4 days. And let me tell you, it's unbelievable. This wasn't a subtle thing, obviously. I went from bouncing around like I am now.
You were well before, you said.
To incapacitated, not able to move. And he was watching it happen for 4 days.
Yeah, it's terrible what you went through. That's terrible. You know, it's brutal. You get worse after your surgery, and they instrumented your LV. You don't have to go through the aortic valve. Damage to the aortic valve and acute worsening. If anybody's going to have that problem, it would be you. You know, it's you had a pre-existing aortic valve abnormality with a flail leaflet. The BNP pre-procedure is extremely high. That's something you see with funny valve lesions. It sort of puts you at high risk for developing heart failure, which we kind of, I guess knew, but...
But they should have warned me of the risk ahead of time. They had a responsibility
to. Or at least said, we're going to do this, or we want to do this. Looking at the numbers, you tell me your blood pressure is low, you're in shock. I mean, it would fit with the aortic valve being damaged at the time of the catheter. I don't know how you could say it wasn't acute aortic regurgitation. They have an x-ray, but if they hadn't, they would have heard of listening to your lungs. They should have just come and told you you're getting worse and discussed why they thought that might be. You know what I mean? And they should have told you and said, we need to surgery now for this reason.
They actually misrepresented it.
They have a psychiatric and not putting something in their nose. And they should discuss with you as well.
They claimed it was psychiatric by withholding the diagnosis that they were surreptitiously tracking, so it was very sneaky.
That's terrible. Complications happen, but you have to be transparent. Or better thing to do, you know, I'm sorry this has happened, I'm forced by the angiogram, you know, I really need surgery now. And, you know, a disclosure probably would have saved everybody a lot of trouble, you know.
Reported the shortness of breath at rest shortly after the catheterization. The 17th, there was the initial diagnosis of pulmonary edema. Interstitial markings have increased since previous of 2 days before, since admission, And February the 18th, he writes, stable for now, shortness of breath associated with stress, not heart failure. This is while he's tracking, surreptitiously tracking
so
the
that's,
lab.
So that's where we get into problems. This is where we kind of get
this
problems.
This is where it gets funky.
Anxiety. Yeah. I had somebody post-angiogram whose blood pressure was going down. I would not usually think of psychiatric disorders. If you have a sudden increase in the amount of regurgitant blood in the left ventricle, your ventricle can't comply with that, and you get sick. You have edema.
Abdominal edema, basically sitting over a toilet, vomiting repeatedly.
And you didn't have that before the angiogram. Yeah,
so and many
again,
issues.
People, you got, that's not psychiatric. You had the findings. Key for me is that you have the development of interstitial edema on your chest x-ray.
Police claimed that there were no complications resulting from cardiac cath, but he was tracking the complications.
The blood work that you show, that's hard to explain otherwise.
He was tracking it through the BUN to CR test that he arranged in advance. So
you know, I mean, anxiety and stress doesn't do that to your BUN. You know, you're volume overloaded. Acute renal failure, I'm not responding to diuretics.
One of my friends is a specialist medical doctor. She said that the physical changes are audible by a stethoscope.
The changes of the fluid on the lungs and the other changes, that's hard to explain away. They should have had a different explanation other than anxiety. They should just come and told you. you know what I mean?
They knew. He was making money off invoicing the BC Ministry of Health for psychiatric services.
Right.
Because had he arranged immediate surgery on the 16th when I went into shortness of breath arrest, he wouldn't have been able to invoice. The staff, as you can see, were actually surreptitiously tracking us for 4 days, and nothing was said except everything's fine. And then it was only on further examination of my medical records that someone notified me that I had been diagnosed with anxiety in the hospital. I actually meditate, and one of the things he claimed were objective observations, he criticized me because he's sitting in the bathroom by himself. And basically, at that time, I was biting off death, closing my eyes in a quiet space and just...
To keep yourself calm?
Because I knew I was about to die. I mean, it was like, it was clear to me. And so I'm actually getting criticized, like, as this is a psychiatric...
Is this your way of coping?
The psychiatrist came in and asked me about my relationships with women and asked me to describe my mood today and these kind of things. And
that's kind of odd.
This is Auschwitz territory.
Yeah,
you can probably see by the lab results physiologically what I was going through. We're talking about a level of suffering which is unimaginable. And he was watching it happen for 4 days.
Justified to have concerns for sure. And I was wondering what and did you ask him, like, what's this a... Was this a complication of my cath? Like he said no, or what did he say?
I have this formal complaint response letter. He claimed that there were severe complications in advance of the cardiac catheterization. Okay, but you can see by the cardiac cath report there were no congestive heart failure complications,
right.
And there was certainly no cardiogenic shock based on the readings. He said the valve was not ruptured, and that your condition stabilized after the cath, and that the symptoms you're reporting were psychiatric in nature.
That doesn't explain your blood test, though. That's kind of funny. That's bizarre.
So, the aftermath, obviously. I entered surgery on the 20th in complete cardiogenic. Patient had significant renal, respiratory, hepatic dysfunction going to surgery. The ejection fraction dropped to 15%.
Yeah.
I bet that was generous, too.
That's fair enough. This is an anesthetic record.
Okay.
So they probably had a TEE, so something they put down your throat.
They did.
That's probably the intraoperative findings. So your heart function was not happening during the OR.
The cardiac surgeon stated that I was not expected to survive surgery based on these, despite being given a normal operative risk previously.
Yeah, your risk should have been really low,
It was less than 1%.
That would have been my guess,
It was less than 1%, that was what I was provided.
Yeah, it was quite a bit higher by the time you went to surgery I can look up, what your score is. It would have been higher with the renal impairment and the CHF and everything else. I'd be willing to come up with something for you,
Okay.
So you want something that would support what you think happened, or
not what I think happened, the medical facts.
Okay.
There were no congestive heart failure complications prior to cardiac catheterization. There were severe cardiac cath complications, respiratory, renal, and hepatic, that were withheld.
Sure.
And misrepresented as the product of psychiatric disease.
Right.
Thus preventing me from receiving emergency surgery. I've actually had this verified by a medical doctor. He's a scientific guy, and he glued in that my heart walls were hypertrophied in advance of cardiac cath. When I went into surgery 4 days later, my left ventricular heart walls were paper thin and floppy. So something to the effect of confirmation of the severe volume overload. My lungs were filling with fluid. It was triggering spikes in all these systemic cardiac markers like BUN to CR,
right.
ALT. My ALT going to surgery was 1,000 plus. This was extant from what I've been told going into surgery, and it didn't happen after surgery because it dropped rapidly. It didn't happen during the surgery.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
The only way that I pieced together what had happened, because no one explained anything to my family or me, the only way that I pieced it together was by discussing this with my family doctor, with my personal code of ethics. There's no way I want anyone to go through that, because not many people would have survived it.
Yeah.
Because I'm physically strong. My doctor said that most people would have been taken out within several hours.
You can.
He's not really describing malpractice, is he? Because that pertains more to like medical errors, where Vyselaar is describing something deliberate over a 4-day period.
Yeah, yeah.
something different.
The kinds of conditions you described fell, I think, more into the realm of almost criminal issues.
Yes, I agree.
Practice issues. And in that regard, of course, that's way out of our league.
Yeah.
And you then have to find ways in which either with through police investigation or find some other ways in which the Crown will want to consider charges.
Yeah. Which makes that sort of outside of the realm of the College of Physicians as well, because they don't really investigate anything deliberate along those lines. Is that correct? It's more like a question of what standard of care?
I think you're right. I think so. What they do is they investigate the conduct of physicians under the Health Professions Act. So they're, they have limitations in terms of what they can and can't do. So
yeah,
that's true.
Be drawing the line in the sand now, and any further unwelcome communications, they're going to start logging, and they're going to come with a big log if they continue to the police department, and it won't probably be me, it'll go up to the detective office, and they'll just go through a word out for you.
Apart from all of this, apart from the entire conversation, I want you to know that it's also important for you to be able to live your life as well. The last thing I would want to find out is that this has been an all-encompassing fixation that is creating stress and therefore shortening your life.